Hey guys, this is David Kwan here. So after playing Splinter Cell Conviction and having gotten 3DS recently, I just wondered like how, you know, Splinter Cell 3D was. I didn't even realize that they released Chaos Theory and ported it to the 3DS. So I was just like, wow, that's interesting. And I love Chaos Theory. That's like one of my favorite games ever. And so I was really excited to see how that happened. And I just want to kind of just be reminded of how Chaos Theory was, because I remember being, because I remember thinking after playing Conviction and just like, man, I really miss the type of game that Chaos Theory was. This methodical stealth game where you're hiding in the shadow and you have all these gadgets. You have the light meter, you have the sound meter, you're paying attention to your surroundings, and you have so many gadgets to utilize. I have fond memories of Chaos Theory. So I rented this game through Gamefly, popped it into my 3DS, and I was shocked, in a bad way. I don't know. I have to wonder, has this game not aged really well? Like, do the graphics of this game... Okay, maybe on the PS2 they look like just like this. But did the Xbox version look this bad? Like, graphically speaking, this is not a good display of 3DS's capabilities. I played Resident Evil Revelations. And yeah, these graphics are pretty horrible. And the loading times, what's happening? Like, this is it. DS uses cartridges. It doesn't use CDs. Why does it have these gigantic loading times? It doesn't make any sense. Even the PS2 version had shorter loading times than this. And that version had a fairly significant loading time. This is Splinter Cell 3D is definitely the worst version of Splinter Cell 3, Chaos Theory that you could ever play. If somebody never experienced Chaos Theory, and wants to experience it, stay away from the 3DS version. You want to experience it on some other platform. PS2, Xbox, PC, the HD version on the PS3, the HD version on the 360, anything but the 3DS version. And that's not really only because of the graphics. Graphics are horrible. There's frame rate issues, the long loading times, but you only get one save. And you can just save once throughout the entire game, and I guess that has to do with the DS's capabilities, whatever, but that really sucks. And the controls, I found them, you know, tolerable, but at the same time, this is not, like, Splinter Cell Chaos Theory is a complex game that is not meant for these controls. The whole, most of the actions are done on the touchpad. And it's such a weird thing to, like, sneaking up on this guy and to grab him. Like, I'm rotating the camera so that, you know, the camera is in the right direction and Sam is following it. And then I have to wait for the grab this guy interact button to pop up on the touch screen and then hit the touch screen as soon as it pops up. It's like, I'm like, it's so weird. So controls are something that I tolerated and I didn't mind too much, but I never got completely used to it. It never felt comfortable, is the thing. So I didn't beat the entire game on the 3DS, because I mean, I beat Splinter Cell Chaos Theory like 5 times on many other platforms. So I just wanted to see how it was. Maybe it's the fact that the game has aged well and I have this like nostalgia goggles on, and so maybe I'm looking back at Splinter Cell Chaos Theory too fondly. I don't know, but I just wanted to see like if there was a point to this port at all. I don't know why Ubisoft would make this port other than to say, hey Konami, so you did a port of Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater and for the 3DS. Well, here's our port of our third game in our rival franchise. Which is interesting. It's like a parallel, you know, because Kojima Productions did release its third Metal Gear Solid game and ported it over to the 3DS. I have not played MGS Metal Gear Solid Snake Eater 3D yet. So, you know, I don't have any opinion on that, whatever. But I do know from reading around that general consensus is that Splinter Cell 3D is horrible, even just graphically speaking also, while Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater 3D is, controls-wise, it's messy, as I expect, because Metal Gear Solid 3 is a complex game. although it there's also a lot of comments I've been reading. It's like, it's not that bad, which is probably like, it's going to be my, might be me, because I played the PSP Metal Gear Solid games, and, you know, I didn't mind them too much. I played Portable Ops just fine. But the comment is, like, the graphics of Metal Gear Solid 3D Snake Eater, because while they're on a small screen, and that's the problem, the 3D effects bring a lot to the experience, you know? Splinter Cell 3D effects on the 3DS does nothing. It's like it doesn't even exist on this thing. The graphics are horrible, the controls are bad, you can only save one time. I just don't see the point of this port at all. Other than the fact that, like, hey, Nintendo guys, if you never play Splinter Cell Chaos Theory, here it is. Where's the market for this? Who would buy this, you know? I could see why someone might buy, like, Metal Gear Solid 3D, Snake Eater 3D. God, it's hard to say that. Metal Gear Solid Snake Eater 3D. As a big Metal Gear fan, you want to see the 3D effects, and, you know, maybe. But even that's questionable. But this port just makes no sense to me whatsoever. It's definitely the worst version of Splinter Cell Chaos Theory. Such an awesome game, tainted by this awful port.